Everybody, this is Jeffrey at BetterWestCoastSwing.com and here at the Ballroom Marina, the beautiful Ballroom Marina. So if you're ever in Reno, Nevada, please don't stop on by. But I want to talk about counting today. Now, guys, we have pattern counts, and a lot of you don't know this, but we have music counts too. Now, musicians always will go 1, 2, 3, 4. You know, John Lennon goes 1, 2, 3, 4. And dancers go 5, 6, 7, 8. Why? Well, as dancers, we use 8, 1 through 8. As musicians, they typically use 1 through 4. And now, I played the drums, so I really didn't understand a whole lot about reading music and notes and stuff as I was growing up. But when I got into dance and ballroom dance, I learned a lot about musicality and a lot about how things are counted and how they're phrased. Basically, there's 12-bar blues, but most contemporary music is 32 beats. That's what a phrase is. There's some weird music out there that doesn't do that, but 99% of the music we dance to is going to be either 32 beats or 48, depending if it's blues. But if we just deal with the 32 counts. So if I counted 1 through 32, that's one full phrase. But let's just break it down and keep it simple. Pattern counts are 1 through 6 or 1 through 8. For basic. So if I do my pushes and passes, I go 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. Simple, all right? Whips are 8 counts because we add 2 beats. We got 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And that makes a basic count pattern. So if we did 2 sugar pushes, 2 passes, and 2 whips, that's what I have my classes always warm up with. It just helps your brain get going. But guys, if we counted that and we just kept going 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, we're counting patterns. 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. That's just patterns, 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 okay? After a while, you gotta go, okay, I understand it's 6 counts, 8 counts, 10 counts, 12 counts. It doesn't matter how many counts the pattern is. But what the music's doing is going 1 through 8, 1 through 8, 1 through 8, 1 through 8. So up to 32, and then it starts in the phrase. So guys, here's what I'm going to suggest you do. As soon as you get comfortable with your pattern counts, we all know that girls, 1, 2 is your walk every single time. And so what we want to feel is understand that walk could be a different count. It doesn't matter because if I'm counting, so I'm going to do the girls part, guys, just to do the girls. But I'm going to do 2 sugar pushes in a row. Watch, listen. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4. You're like, wait, what? Yeah. So what we just did is we danced the music, not the pattern. That's a difference. That's huge. So girls, this is just as important for you to know who those ones are. Robert Royston, Mario, all these guys teach some awesome, awesome musicality classes. Go take their classes. Okay? Go take their classes. Okay? If I find videos, I'll post their stuff on my website. But they are so brilliant with their musicality. I've learned so much from these guys. And being honest, but there's a lot of things we just don't know to do. And as beginner dancers. And so I'm not saying a beginner, brand new beginner should start rolling, counting their 1 through 8s. That's just gonna screw your brains. When you get comfortable with it, that's when we start counting. But the sooner you start counting 1 through 8 for your patterns, the faster you're gonna get better because you'll stop worrying about counting patterns and you'll start hearing the music. Because the one in the music, as a pro, we spend our entire dance career trying to hit that damn one, trying to accent that one. Now, can I accent it every 4 beats? Yeah, absolutely. If I can do something every 4 beats too. But like if you listen to music, the 5 is a softer one sound, excuse me, than the 1 is. The 1 is the hard one, and the 5 is a soft one. So musicians will deal with that, but as a dancer, I'm looking for the heavy one. So every time I hit my accent, and Robert Royston does his do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, di kind of thing, and he goes back to go. So if you haven't ever learned that or taken any classes, take Royston's classes. Those are awesome. And Mario, I've taken like 4 or 5 of Mario's intensives. And those are so good because you learn so much about music. But so start counting 1 through 8 as soon as you feel comfortable and just practice basics, basics. Listen, I'm going to do the whole thing one time all the way through. Watch, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 32 counts. New phrase starts on 1. Then I did a shirt push, a pass. I did a whip. So I did 6 count, 6 count, 8 count, 6 count. I think that's 32. So 18 plus 8 is, yeah, I think so, 32. Okay, so anyways, if I counted it 1 through 32, it's like this. It goes 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10, 11, and 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30, 31, 32. There we go. That was 32. That's just screwy. Don't count that way, but I want you to see it. So I got to 32, and I started over. All right? So just work on counting through 8. If you do 32 counts, if you figure it out, there's 24. If you do 4 6-count patterns and 1 8-count pattern, that's going to equal 32. It's just math. Math never lies, except for when I'm trying to choreograph. So anyways, guys, I hope that helps you learn to count 1 through 8 as soon as you possibly can. Stop counting patterns and just start counting music. And you're going to hear a lot about the music when you start hearing where the ones are. All right, everybody, I am so happy to be helping you guys and so happy to be doing this. So thank you so much for the support, and share this with your friends. And be sure you go to betterwestcoastswing.com and all the free content we have on there. And I am so happy to be here for you. So have a wonderful day. And as always, always be a good human.